If you have any question from previous session, please let me know. So during the first method, we have deployed a new virtual machine. Let's say we have installed with Windows Server 2012 operating system as 4 GB of memory.
Can you please increase the size of the letters?
Sorry?
Can you increase the size of the letters because it is showing so small?
Okay. Is it fine?
Yes.
So we have created a virtual machine with these specifications. GB hard disk. We have installed with some operating system. So on the back end, .vmx, .vmdk, .nvram files are created. Okay. If I ask you to create some 20 machines like that, it took around 30 to 40 minutes time. The OS installation only took a lot of time for you, like around 20 minutes. Okay. So if I ask you to create 20 machines like that, on an average, it will take some 15 to 20 hours for you to prepare them. Create a virtual machine and then install operating system on every machine, then install the drivers as well. That takes a lot of time for you. So just to avoid the time to build virtual machine, VMware has developed a feature called cloning. Something like very easy example is your friend has already downloaded a new, maybe around 4 GB capacity size, and it took him around 4 hours to download it. If he's available next to you, if you want the same copy of data, whatever the movie, whatever it may be, you will not download it again. Don't want to wait for 4 hours. You just copy paste that file. He is available next to you. The same way here as well, instead of waiting for 30 to 40 minutes for another virtual machine, you just copy paste this virtual machine. These are all files only. If you copy paste, whatever the data that is stored inside this VMDK, you will get exactly the another copy. You can get another copy of virtual machine from this existing machine, just like copy pasting its files. You will get another copy of machine. It's called cloning, duplicating an existing virtual machine, copy pasting the files of a virtual machine. So you can clone in any of the power state. If the source machine, even if it is powered on, you can close. Even if it is powered off, you can close. You can clone. There is no difference in cloning. But only the power on machine, if you are cloning, it will take some extra time. So if you power on a machine which is running, it's called hot clone. Clone. So if you want to clone it, basically select a virtual machine, right click on the mouse, you will see an option called clone, clone to a VM, just give a new name, new display name, not inside the server name, it's just display name, OS it will have a different name, and then select where you want to place and which GSXI and which hard disk you want to store the virtual machine. Here you will have an option called customization. We will see what is this optional step. Just click on finish. If you follow this navigation, you will be able to clone a machine. Even if it is in power on state, power off state, there's both the same procedure. You will get another machine. So whatever that is data you placed here, if it has only C drive 40 GB, here also you'll get C drive 40 GB. If you have another hard disk of like 500 GB here, and let's say you have installed with some Oracle database here, here also that will be copy pasted. But you need this machine for something else, not for Oracle. Then what you have to do? Again, you have to uninstall the data. Whatever that is there on the source machine will be copy pasted exactly the same. So in this case, it is drawback. So I don't want Oracle database here. I have to uninstall it again and install something else again. So that takes some extra time. So that is the one drawback. And once the cloning is completed, if the two copies are separated and there is no relation between this machine and this machine, whatever it was there before cloning, that is exactly copy pasted. After cloning, if you place any data here, let's say the same Oracle database installed, it will be still here only. It will not replicate here. After cloning, there is no relation. They're completely two different machines. Oracle will be running here only. It will be plain OS only. If you can install something else.
See, if we clone, the virtual machine and name will be the same for both, or it will be different?
That's what I'm giving. You're giving a new name here. The display name is different. Okay. And there is, again, I'll come to that point as well. There will be inside guest OS. The computer name will be, host name will be different.
Okay.
Display name will be different. Host name will be different. Here in this case, display name will change, because it will not accept same name in the same vCenter. It will be, let's say, 46. Display name is different, but inside the host name is 45. It will be still 45 here. Coming to that point, please wait. Display name has to be, must be different. Otherwise cloning, we cannot click on finish. Even if you click finish, that will fail, because you have given the same name in the same vCenter, it will not accept. Let's say test VM 45 is there. I'm building a new virtual machine again. Test VM 45. So here it will show. Same name exists already in the location. So enter a new name. But inside there will be a different name, that's called host name, that will be still same. So after cloning, whatever you place here, it will be here. Whatever you place here, let's say you install SQL here, it will be still here. So it will not replicate to and fro. It will not replicate anything back. They're completely two different machines. And even we will not be able to know from where you have cloned it, until unless if you check the computer host name, you will be able to understand. Otherwise, we will not be able to understand from where you have cloned this machine. But in any network, so in any network, let's say the computer name, IP address of a machine, network address, and security identifier for Windows machines. These three values should not be same for any two devices in the network. If you feel like they are in one network, any two devices, maybe in the virtual machines or physical servers or whatever it is, a printer, a telephone, whatever it may be. Name of a device should not be same for any two devices in a same network. Something like India is one network. So any two guys doesn't have same mobile number. If two guys in India have same number, we know what happens. Miscommunication, right? The same way, any two devices in the network should not have same name, same IP address, same SID. As of now, just remember, IP address is like mobile number for us, and IP address for a device, server or any device in the network, and SID is like Aadhaar card. Even Aadhaar card number is same, you know what happened. The same way, here also the same way, any two devices in a network should not have same name, IP address, and SID. They must be changed. The name I'm talking about inside the OS, outside the display name is already different. That doesn't matter. The problem is inside the guest voice. This is the name I'm talking about, and the IP address is something like network address. We will discuss about it later. What is IP address? How we assign that? We will only assign to that machine. We will assign like later. And as of now, this you must change them. But you clone any virtual machine, all these three values also will be same on the destination machine here. But we must change them. You can change before you clicking finish button here. Here itself, you can change them. Name, SID, and IP address, you can change. And once you click on finish, this new VM will completely get a new computer name to VM46, whatever the name that you enter here, and new IP, new SID. Or if you skip here, and if you click on finish button, you can change them later. And you should be careful how to change them later, and you should be knowing as well. Before you bring it to the network, you must change them. In the same network, if before you connect, you must change them. There you should be careful. You have to disconnect its network adapter, then power on, then change it. And you should be knowing how to change its IP address, how to change its name, and how to change its IP address. But we will see anyway. Technically, we will see later as of now. But you should be knowing what is customization. Changing up these three values is called customization that you can do here itself. Before you click on finish button, you can change, or even if you click on finish, then you can change them later. And also cloning. So you will get a virtual machine quickly on the presenter. Let's say test VM45 we have prepared last week with Windows Server 2004 on it. Right click. Clone, clone to virtual machine. VM46. Where you want to place them. Select an ESXi machine and its hard disk location as well. Wherever you have enough free space, select that one. I'm selecting the 1.6 terabyte free space. Compatibility is exceeded. So if you want to customize, here itself you can customize, or you can do it later as well. If you want to modify any RAM and CPU, you can modify here or later. But I want to do the customization of the name of the customization, that let it be the same. Name of the machine. Okay, that is fine. Just I can give this lab organization name, that can be no problem. Yeah, the name of the machine that I'm talking about, the inside guest OS. It copies the same, right? If you have to change here. If you want to give something new name, here you have to give. Or you say use virtual machine name. Whatever the name I'm giving, the display name, it will be exactly matches the same name. But it is recommended. The display name and OS name should be same. It's called host name. As of from now onwards, I will call it as host name. The display VM display name and the host name of the machine should be same. So that's why I will select use the virtual machine name. Whatever the display name I'm giving, it will take into the OS level as well. License, if you want to apply, you can apply here or later you can do. This is not a mandatory step. This is a mandatory step. This you can skip. Password. And if you don't know the password of this machine, if you clone it, here also you will get the same password, which you are already not aware of it. It's of no use. You will not be able to log in. But if you want to change during cloning, you can change. Okay. In this process, even though you are not aware of this initial password, here it will reply with a new password. Okay, even though if you are not aware of this password, it's okay. Like once the cloning is done, you will get new machine with new password. So that is one of the method you can change its password. Time zone, it's not a mandatory thing. If you want to change any time zone, you can change the time zone. If it is a Linux machine, if you want to run any command during the cloning, you can use it. Otherwise, you can skip it. Network address here. You have to change the network IP address of this machine. Here we can enter new IP address so that the new it will get a new IP address. We have already changed name. IP address will change at this step. Just canceling. I'm not here. If you want to add into domain, this is, you can do it any point of time. It's not mandatory thing. Another important thing is this one. Just to get a new SID, we are using this option. So this will change now. These three are very critical things. Rest of the things, even if you don't change, no problem. Your organization will accept it. They will run it. If you want to modify the values, you can modify it. Next, if you want to modify any hard disk, you can modify. You can remove, let's say I don't want the second hard disk, I can delete it. I want only one hard disk, I can finish. In older version, that skipping of hard disk was not there. Now it is trying to clone a new VM. Depends on the data on the source machine. Whatever the data that you have placed here, it will try to copy paste and it takes some time. Depends on the data on the source machine. If the source machine is power on and if you are cloning, take some 5 minutes extra than cloning a powered off machine. Any questions from the cloning? So just duplicating an existing virtual machine. When you want quickly more number of VMs, if you have some virtual machine here, you will clone it as it is. Whatever the data that is available here, exactly copy paste it. If there is any unnecessary data, that is a drawback. We will not choose cloning in this case. If you are sure that you have only plain operating system, we will clone it. So any other question here? So even if you clone with unnecessary data or whatever the extra hard disk, doesn't matter. So the customer will ask you to create a machine. He will give you a VM name, what OS you need, how much of RAM, CPU and hard disk. Your machine will be, at the time of submission, should be exactly matches the requirement. If you place any unnecessary data, it will escalate again. Because he just requested a machine with this specification, but you are giving him unnecessary data. Well, with the cloning, you should be careful what is there on the source machine. You should be aware, then you submit it. Fine, any questions? Third option, we will see about the third way of VM deployment. Template. This is also almost equivalent to a cloning only. It's almost like copy pasting an existing machine. So customer will be frequently, like whoever the requester, the application team will be frequently requesting for a virtual machine with its name, OS, RAM, CPU, and hard disk. If you build first method, it will take 40 minutes. If you build using cloning, it depends on the data on the source machine, it takes some time. But both of them, time consuming tasks. If there is an unnecessary data on the source, that is also again unnecessary time. So for that reason, there is another option called standard image called templates. Even if you're mobile, if you're driving, if you're getting a call, if you want to disconnect, there'll be standard messages will be displayed. In meeting right now, call you later. I'm driving, some few messages will be there. If you see their names, basically it's a template messages. Someone prepared those images for you already. Here also something like that only. We have prepared machine for quick deployment. Instead of replying them while you are driving, you have already prepared that message. Our mobile company itself prepared for you. Okay. Here also for quick reply. Here also the same. For quick VM deployment, we will prepare the templates for ourselves. We will build a virtual machine. We will install some operating system. We will not place any other data. We will just use 2 GB of RAM, 2 CPUs, and C:40 GB. Okay. Virtual machine will be ready. And if you have a machine like this, it is possible to power on. You can power on this machine. You can run applications on this virtual machine. But we will not use it for anything. Just prepare this machine and we will convert this machine into template. This is called template. You will not be able to power on. You can't power on. We can't run applications. Not possible to power on. It's not possible to run the applications. Okay. We have converted that machine itself into a template. This VM itself turned into a template, and now it has the same specifications and same operating system which was available on source machine. Now this will disappear. The machine itself will turn into a template. Now you will see only this template. You cannot power up, you cannot run application in it. Then what is the use of it? Using it, you can create virtual machines. That's it. Using this template, you can create virtual machines quickly out of it. A machine will be ready with the same specifications, however it was there on the source. Not possible to change the OS. Whatever the OS it was already installed in the hard disk, the same copy will be available here as well. This RAM, CPU, hard disk, if you want to change these values, it's less than 10 seconds only we can change. This is not a problem. If you want to increase memory, CPU, hard disk, we can increase now quickly. Less than 1 minute of task, we can do them. Now you can use this machine to power on and running to run the applications. Power on is possible. You can run the applications. Any number of VMs you can deploy out of it. It's like you have a CD. Any number of machines you can install the operating system the same way. But at a time, it's not possible to create some from, you have a template at a time. If you want to deploy 20 machines, it's not possible. Even from the cloning, the same problem. If you want to deploy multiple VMs at a time using this template or cloning, it's not possible. One at a time, you have to do initiate one at a time. Parallel, you can proceed, but you have to initiate one at a time. That means once you are deploying VM, let's say it is taking 5 to 10 minutes. Meanwhile, you can initiate one more. Parallel you can deploy, but one at a time you have to deploy. And you will get the same OS. If you want a different OS, you need to have another template. Understood what is a template? And this, we, as a VMware administrator, we will only prepare these templates. No one will ask you to prepare a template. We will only prepare and keep them. In just a matter of 5 to 10 minutes, your machine will be ready. Let's say even 15 minutes. Your machine will be ready in 15 minutes as per the exact requirement, however a customer asked for. VM name, with the specific OS, RAM, CPU, hard disk. No unnecessary data. That's what we wanted, and it is ready quickly. We don't place any unnecessary data on the machine which we are converting into a template. Only keep the operating system and specifications, whatever we need. Understood? We'll see how to create a template now. Just right click on the virtual machine, you will see an option called template, convert into template. There will be another option called clone into template. When you say clone into template, this version will be still there. You will get another copy of template. When you say convert into template, this machine will not be available. This machine itself will be turned into a template. Understood the difference? Clone into template, convert into template. Now we'll see. Still cloning. We will take any other small VM. I'll just create another. Small VM I'll create for our quick deployment. There is a machine available named test 45. You have installed some operating system in it, and you have configured some RAM, CPU, hard disk as per your company standards. Now you just go to template, convert into template. This machine will not be available here anymore. Test VM will be disappeared. Okay, test VM 45, test 45 is disappeared. Then where can you see the template? Just go to templates here, VMs and templates view, the next view. If you expand the data center, here you will see that template. The icon itself looks different. Test 45, you will see these are the virtual machines. Test VM 45, test VM, just VM 46, ESX 11 are the virtual machines. The icons looks different. These are the new virtual machine, test G, test 45 are the templates. The icons itself looks different. I don't want this one, I'm deleting others. Okay, test 45, this is the template. So if you want to deploy from this template, right click on it, you will not see any power on, power off, edit setting, nothing. If you want, you can delete from it from here, or you can create new VM from this template. New VM from this template, test 456. It will ask where you want to place the VM. Same like cloning option, it will ask you to select. And here also we need to do customization, that is also mandatory step. Customization here also we can do. Test 45, I'm deploying. The VMs you can see here, only templates will be, you have to go to this view. Test 45 is being prepared from that template. If you follow this navigation, you will be able to create a VM from a template. So it will deploy a new VM from this template. If you want to change the resources, you can change now. And worse, it's not possible to change. Customization is mandatory. And very common question here about template is that what is the difference between cloning and a template? So both are used to create VMs quickly, but here there is a possibility of unnecessary data. This is cloning. Both machines you can power on and power run applications here, but here you cannot power on. Only the deployed machine you can power on run the applications. Another drawback here, if you have any unnecessary data, that also will be copy pasted here. Unnecessary time we have to space to clean up that. And here it will have only the plain operating system, so it will be ready quickly. Which method will you pick now? If I ask you to create a virtual machine with the specification, which method will you pick?
First method only.
Sorry?
First method only.
Cloning or template?
It is a cloning.
If there is any unnecessary data, what you will do it?
Then we can clean up the unnecessary data, because in that you are not having any power or if there is any issue in that.
This machine you can power, right? You don't need to power on this machine. You can power on this machine. That's what you need, right?
Okay. For power on, it is required for if there's any issue in that VM, like if you run any application, sometimes it will be struck or and if anything happens, then we have to restart and all these things will be there. Maybe.
Application is not here. It is having only plain OS. You have deployed a VM from out of it. After deploying a VM, there is no relation between them. If you have application problem, something like you have installed application here. That anyway you have to fix here, even if it is cloning, you have installed a new application, you have to fix there. Okay. Then what is the advantage? If you have an application here you have an application. If you have a problem, if you fix here, how will it fix it here? There is no relationship between them. And again, you are saying like I'll clean up. If there is any unnecessary data, you will clean up. That will take extra time, right? You want to uninstall the programs, reboot multiple times and all. Here you have got exactly however you want, you got it here immediately. There is nothing wrong in your way of thinking, but you see logically which is helpful, which you want to quickly deploy a machine. So which one is a feasible option?
For template is a feasible option if you want to deploy fast.
Yes, so that's what we prefer, template than cloning. If you don't have template, then we will depend on cloning. Let's say you don't have templates in your organization, you want to clone, you want another machine quickly and you feel that there is no application in it, then we will prefer. Let's say you have another, there is advantage of cloning as well. Let's say you have an application already installed here and tested working fine. You need another machine with the same application, then you can clone it. It depends, the use case may be different. It depends on the scenario or situation. Got it? Fine, so thanks for your response. But anyway, if you are interactive, then only we can learn better. So now we understood what is the disadvantage of over template and also vice versa. What is better, in which scenario we will use cloning instead of template. So like that. Even if it is wrong, no problem. Just convey your response. Okay, we will see. Nothing wrong. So we are here to learn. Good, Arun. Thank you. Now we understood the template, right? From template, quickly we can build a fresh VM. So that's what we wanted. So instead of cloning, we will prefer here. And technically, if you go to any interview, there will be a question like this: what is the difference between cloning and template? So one thing, you can power on both the machines here. Here you cannot power on. That's not a matter. And another thing, if you have any unnecessary data, that also will be copy pasted here, which is template is advantage compared to this method. Fine. And another interview question. So this is one. How will you modify or update a template? Let's say on this machine 2 GB RAM is there, right? When you're deploying a VM, it will deploy a VM with 2 GB only, but I need 4 GB RAM. Let's say it's less than 1 minute of task, you will just modify it. Every time you deploy, your organization standard is changed to 4 GB now. Every time you deploy a VM, you need to change it. Every time you have to change. Then if you fix it here itself, you don't need to change that again. Even if it is less than 1 minute of task, you don't need to change that. You just deploy VM, machine will be ready with 4 GB immediately. At least RAM and CPU is less than 1 minute of task. What if patches? This template was prepared 1 year back. It is running with 1 year back operating system. There are a lot of patches are released now. Your organization also wants you to update a machine with the latest patches. Once you deploy a VM, again, you need to take time to install the patches here. That will take 30 minutes again. Unnecessarily, you have to spend time. And then if you apply patches here itself, if you deploy a VM, that machine will be ready with the patches. That's the logic. So now to apply patches, you are not able to power on this machine. And how to apply patches now? Any logic? Anyone can guess? How to apply changes in the template? This is also another interview question. So everyone who has learned about VMware will be aware of what is a template, how to build a VM template. Everybody will answer, but this kind of questions will understand, like will be able to answer by someone who is already worked on it. So just to know whether you really worked or not, this kind of questions they will ask you during the interviews. Okay, so using this template, we are building virtual machines, right? The same way we can convert this template into VM again back. Okay, convert that machine back into a template into back into a machine. Here you do the changes, whatever you want, RAM, CPU or patches, whatever it is. Basically patches we may need to do frequently on a template. Convert this template back into VM, apply the changes, whatever patches, RAM, CPU, if there is any other setting, whatever it may be. If you want to modify whatever it is, modify it. Then again, we know the changes are ready, then convert it back into template. That's the answer. Convert the template into a VM. Apply the changes, whatever the change that he may ask you. Convert the VM back into a template. Understood the logic? So we will convert the template back into the virtual machine, apply the changes and convert back into template. Fine, any other question here? Now we have created a template, and from the template again we have created a virtual machine. Test 45 is ready. See, test 456 is deployed from the template. Right. So any other question? Fourth method, there is something called P2V and slash V2V, physical to virtual, virtual to virtual. This topic we will see during the advanced topic at the end of the course. So even there is a physical machine, physical computer, with Windows Server, let's say 2012 operating system, some application is running here. And you have like 100 physical servers you have, and now you heard about VMware, ESXi, all these 100 machines you can run on one or two ESXi machine. Now you're interested about that, and you want the same application, however it is running on the physical machine, as it is copy pasted. So directly it is not possible. We have to create a new VM, install OS, install OS and then install application. As of now, this is possible. But customer wanted as it is, they want to copy their data and application, installation files, everything as it is into this machine, this another virtual machine. So for that, VMware has developed something called converter. Using that converter file, we can converter software, we can convert exactly the physical server into a virtual machine. You don't need to create any virtual machine. When you run that converter, it will convert the physical computer into virtual computer. Then you don't need your physical computer. Okay, this will have whatever the data that was here. You don't need to install any OS. And the same application, however it was running on the physical machine, it will run here now. Now once it is running, this virtual machine is as it is running, however it was a virtual machine, physical machine before. Now you don't need this physical machine, right? You can remove this and throw it off, because your machine is running from here. Whatever the application which was dependent on this machine, now it is running from here. Okay, you can throw this physical box now, like that. So there is a process how to convert it. We will see that process later. There are some pre-checks and post-checks available, so we'll do this process later. Fine, any other question? Now, as of now, we have discussed about four methods. Okay. Out of these four methods, the output will be a virtual machine. Customer wanted a virtual machine. So we are creating the output of this, any of the method is a virtual machine. We will see, like, there is one more method, fifth method. After discussing about that fifth method, we will see which method we will prefer out of these five methods. Okay. As of now, there are four methods. Which method will you prefer? Just as usual, as a VMware administrator, whatever it may be, even if it is wrong answer, please tell me, no problem. I need a virtual machine. Let's say I'll just give my VM name, and this is the OS I need, RAM, CPU, hard disk. Which method will you prefer to deploy a VM?
Template.
Good. Any other answer? It's up to you which method you choose. Doesn't matter. At the end of the day, I need a machine with these specifications only. I don't want any unnecessary data on it. Template is the preferred method for this use case at least. Okay. We'll see, one more method is there. We'll see about that as well. And when decide which method we will prefer. So that next method tomorrow we will discuss. If you have any question, please let me know.
can you please share the recordings? Just you are saying.
Okay, all these sections I am uploading in our channel. You can check them out. There are other videos as well.
Which channel we don't know?
Yeah, download. I think I have posted. I don't know. I think. No, you are not there. I'll send you that link. YouTube channel. I'm posting all of them on that YouTube channel.
What are the daily you will say? Just can you share that videos? Then meanwhile we'll get to that.